Hey guys, I'm Jonas. Today we're going to talk about this Northstar sprayer and how I mounted it on my Hustler Fast Track. So stick around. So I've been trying out this new 16-gallon sprayer from Northstar. I had the previous style tank that was the oval tank that had the pump mounted up on top of it. I used that for a lot of years, got some good use out of it, and then I sold the machine that I had that tank mounted to. So for this new machine, I wanted to go with this new cube-style tank. It seems like it's a little bit more compact. I like how the pump is mounted off the end of the tank instead of up on the top. It seems like it's a little more protected that way. This does have a 2.2 gallon per minute pump on it. They were also added the see-through screen there that you can spin off and clean really easy. That's a really nice upgrade that I like on this one. The old tank didn't have that. This one also has the pressure regulator valve with a pressure gauge, so you can actually monitor what pressure you're spraying at, which is another really nice upgrade. They also changed the filler on the top here, put a little bit bigger style filler that sits down smooth when it's closed. So really liking that on this too. So they did some really nice upgrades, added the handles on here to make it a lot easier to grab than what that old style tank was. And they also added the spot on the side here to be able to wind up your hose for storage. So they also changed the wand or the sprayer that comes with it. The old style tank came with just a straight wand that you just squeeze the trigger on. This new one is the pistol grip style sprayer that is, in my opinion, a lot easier to operate. It's easier to hang on to, and it's got a lot better tip on it for making the adjustments. So being able to have the wand sprayer as well as the boomless broadcast sprayer on the front is a really nice combo for what I need to be able to do with this sprayer. So to mount my sprayer onto my Hustler Fast Track, basically the rollover bars you can lock in this position to where it's just straight out. They can either be down in the middle or in the raised position. So this is just one of the positions that you can put the pin in and lock it like this. So basically what I did was just take two pieces of 3/4 inch plywood, cut them to the size that I needed so they were just a hair wider than this rollover bar and just about the width of the tank, cut them, glued them together, screwed them together, so I got a nice, that gives me about 1.5 inch base for this tank to sit on, which should be plenty strong enough even when I've got a full 16 gallons in here. So then I drilled through there to be able to put two bolts down into the rollover bar. And when I drilled into that rollover bar, I put two nut certs in there. So basically a rivet tool that rivets a nut inside of that tube so that I can just screw these bolts down into that nut. I didn't want to drill all the way through the rollover bar. I think it was just a little bit cleaner look, just having the nut in the one side. So that way when I remove this tank, because I don't leave it on there all the time, I remove it when I'm not using it. So it's only on the machine when it's getting used. So when it's off of there and just having those four nuts set into the frame, you don't even notice them. You don't even see that they're there. So it's a lot cleaner look, not having big holes going all the way through there. And I'm always thinking about resale value. You know, I don't want to, when I go to sell this thing, have people asking me, well, why is there holes drilled all the way through there? You know, so it's going to just keep it a little bit nicer, cleaner look when the tank isn't installed on the machine. So when I was mounting this tank on here, I wanted to keep it as far forward as I could, get it up over the rear axle as much as I possibly could. You really don't want to mount it all the way on the very back of your roll bar here. That's just too much weight pushing down on the back of the machine, making the front end of the machine lighter. So I mounted it up as far as I could to where I'm not going to be hitting it with my back or my head or anything while I'm running the machine. I end up scooting the seat forward a little bit more than where I would normally have it, just to help bring my weight forward on the machine. And then I still add, if I'm going to be spraying with a full 16 gallons, I have two 50-pound weights that I put up underneath of my feet on the platform there. So that's another 100 pounds up towards the front of the machine just to help keep that front end good and planted. So if I'm going over some hills or something happens, I'm not worried about that front end coming up as I have a full tank on the back. So that seems to work really well with it set up just in this configuration. This tank does have nuts molded into the bottom of it, so then I just drilled the four holes that lined up with the mounts in the bottom of the tank and bolted up through the bottom of the tank. You've got to be careful to get bolts that are just the right length. If they're too long, you could break through the bottom of the tank. So they don't thread into that tank very far, but there is a good amount of threads that you can screw into and get this tank bolted down nice and secure. So then normally you would have a bracket that bolted onto the back of this tank. If you were mounting it onto like the back of an ATV, it would have the plate bolted onto here that your boomless sprayer would snap into and hang off of the back of the machine and spray behind you. The way that I ran my old machine, I had the boom mounted up on the front so that I could see what I was spraying. It's very nice to be able to just drive forward and watch the spray in front of you and see exactly where you're spraying. So I decided to do that with this machine too, and basically just made a simple bracket that I could bolt to the front of the mower and then bolt that mount to the bracket and be able to mount the boomless sprayer up on the front of the machine. To make that setup work though, I needed a longer hose. Normally the short hose, it's just about 2 feet long or so, connects onto that boomless sprayer, so when it's snapped into its mount on the back here, it just has a short hose, and then you have your long hose for the wand, so when you're spraying with the wand, you've got about 10 to 15 feet of hose or so. So basically what I did was switch the hose. I put the long hose going up to the front of the machine, connected onto the boomless sprayer, and cut it exactly at the length that I needed it, and then I had about 5 feet left over or so. So that's what I connected to the wand, so that I just have a short 5 foot piece of hose to the wand, because most of the time if I'm spraying with the wand, I'm just sitting in the seat of the mower spraying. So I don't need 15 feet worth of hose when I'm just right there. The hose just ends up dragging down and getting tangled up in things. So having a short hose on the wand works just fine for how I'm using it in this setup. So for my mount up front here, basically I just had a piece of scrap steel that was bent at a 90, and I drilled two holes to bolt it onto the front of the machine, and then drilled a couple of holes to mount on the plastic mount for this boomless sprayer that clips into. Very simple setup. That's the only thing that stays mounted on the machine when the sprayer is removed, is that one piece. And really, it's just two bolts. I could unbolt it and take it off very easily, but it's really nothing that's gonna get into my way, so I just leave it bolted onto the machine. Everything else comes off with the tank. When you are mounting that boomless sprayer to the front of the machine, you do need to pay attention to how high it is off the ground. In the owner's manual that comes with this, it'll give you a recommended mounting height. And I tried to stay kind of right in the middle or just a little bit lower than what their recommended height range was. And that helped give me just a little bit more of a concentrated spray. I think right now my overall spray width is about 10 feet or so on this machine. So when you're actually out spraying with it, the height that you have it mounted at, the pressure that you set your regulator at, how fast your machine goes, is all going to determine how many, you know, square feet or acres that you're going to be able to spray per tank, you know, per 16 gallons. So that's something that you have to calculate once you get it mounted onto your machine, and just fill it with water and go do a test spray and measure it out, and then you know how many square feet you're covering and how to actually mix your chemicals when you're ready to start spraying with it. So the next thing I decided to change was how you switched it from the broadcast sprayer to the wand. They come with a quarter turn valve that's mounted right at the bottom of the broadcast sprayer, which is fine if this was mounted on an ATV and it was right behind you. But the only way that I can reach it on the front of the mower is to stop the machine, put the levers out, and then lean all the way forward to switch it. So instead of doing that, I just added another quarter turn valve in the line that's right next to my seat, so I can easily reach down and grab that valve and switch it from broadcast to the wand. So the next thing to figure out was the wiring, how I wanted to hook it up to the battery and mount my on-off switch. In the past, on my old machine, I had had the on-off switch mounted on the handlebars, so that made it really simple flipping it on and off without having to remove my hands from the levers. So I wanted to do the same type of thing on this machine. So basically what I came up with was, this is an on-off switch for like a scooter that I found on Amazon. It was like 10 or 11 bucks. I'll put it in the description down below. But basically what I had to do was, the diameter wasn't big enough for this big of a grip. The handlebars that it's made to go on was only like 7/8, and this is like an inch and a quarter or so. So basically I just ground it out a little bit on the plastic to make it big enough where it sat onto these handlebars fairly well, and then drilled a couple of holes through it to put a zip tie on there. I may end up trying to figure out a way to put like a hose clamp on there or something that's reusable instead of just having to cut the zip tie every time that I want to take it off. But basically I can mount this right on the handlebars, crank the zip tie down, and then position it, you know, just where I want it to be able to flip that switch on and off real easy with my hands just right there on the bars. And then I add a couple of more zip ties down lower on the bars here just to secure the wire back out of my way. So the battery on this fast track is mounted underneath of a cover, and it's not real easy to get to, and there's not a lot of space underneath of there. This new style spray tank only came with clip-on battery leads. So you would clip one onto the positive, one onto the negative, and that's not what I wanted to use on this setup. So I ended up cutting those leads off and using a tinder style lead that would just bolt right onto the battery and be able to use it for my battery tinder during the winter to keep my battery maintained, but then also be able to plug in the wiring for this sprayer, and that lead would just stay permanently mounted to the battery. It does have a fuse in it, so we're not gonna have any issues with something shorting out there. So that way, that stays bolted to the machine. It's easy to just plug it in, unplug it. I know I'm not gonna have any issues with it while I'm spraying. So another upgrade that I wanted to make was how you drain the tank. And they have a little cap that threads onto the end of the tank here, and you remove that cap and the water runs out. But I wanted to be able to get it out and away from my machine so that I wasn't getting chemicals running all over the side of my mower and all over my plywood here. So basically I just took a short piece of clear hose and put a garden hose end on one end that would thread onto the tank, and then I just got a half inch shutoff valve to put on the end here. So when I go to drain this tank, I can hang this out wherever I want it, open the valve and have it running out, you know, on the ground or into a bucket or whatever I'm doing there. But that is something that's very important, I found out with these spray tanks, is when you're done with them, you've got to rinse them out really well. So once you've sprayed all your chemical out of it, get in there with the hose, spray the tank down, let it drain, spray it again, let it drain, spray it again, until there's no more foam or bubbles or anything inside of your tank, so that you've got all the chemical flushed out of it, and then fill the tank up with just a little bit of water, and then run both your sprayers, run the wand and the broadcast sprayer, just to flush everything out of those lines until you're just getting good clean water coming out of them, and then come back and drain the tank again, whatever you've got left in there, get as much of that water out as you can, and that'll really help keep you from having issues with filters getting plugged or tips getting plugged, just by getting as much of that old chemical and then all the water out as you can. So far I've been really happy with this new tank design and the setup that I've got on my machine here. It's been working really well. Overall, you know, I looked at a lot of different sprayers, and it seems like Northstar just seems to be like one of the best bang for your bucks. They're a pretty well-built sprayer for the price range that they're in. I do like this new style, though, and some of the extra features that you get with it, and having the pump that's a little more protected off to the side. And just like the pistol grip wand, you know, that was an upgrade that I had to do to my old pump. But this new tank came with that on it already. So that's really nice. And having the regulator and the recirculate, being able to stir your tank if you need to. So been some really nice upgrades. You know, there is a couple of things that I wish that the cord came with the two different ends, whether you wanted to clamp it onto your battery or bolt it on. That was a nice feature that my old tank had that this new one did not come with. I'd like to see them change that. But other than that, you know, really it's been a nice little setup for your monies. So I'll put some links down in the description below for the tank itself and the parts that I used on this setup. So if you guys want to check those out. If you guys got some good value out of this video, please hit the like button. Consider subscribing. That really helps my channel out a lot. Thank you guys for watching. Have a great day.